Hello and welcome to this video in which I will show you how to make GitHub repositories citable using Zenodo. Citability for repositories is important so that repositories and software packages will be considered as legitimate contributions to research without having to write proxy white papers about them. This way we can advance the state of research software engineering. Let's create a simple demo repository for our publication. Let's name it publication demo and let's set the Readme file and let's use a permissive license, for example, the MIT license. And let's create the repository. Next, let's head to zenodo.org. In Zenodo, you should create your own account and then navigate to the account settings. From there, you should link your GitHub account and your ORCID to Zenodo. This ORCID is optional but recommended. You can create your own ORCID from the ORCID.org website. It simply gives you this persistent digital identifier that distinguishes you from other researchers. And it looks like this. So there is this link to your own ORCID page. Let's head back to Zenodo. Now we can go to the GitHub section. In Zenodo's GitHub section, they list these three steps that we need to perform in order to create the Zenodo publication for our repository. But first we should click this Sync Now button to synchronize our GitHub repositories to Zenodo so that we can find our newly created repository. Once our repositories have synchronized, let's find our newly created repository and switch on the preservation. Now we can head back to our repository and create a new release. We can tag it version 0.1.0 and let's say initial release. Well, we will leave this empty and create the new release. Now it has created the new release. If we go to the GitHub repository, we can also see the initial release here. Now we can head back to Zenodo and go up here and once again synchronize the repository. This will take a little while. Once our synchronization has finished, we can scroll down here to the enabled repositories where we will see our newly created publication. We can, for example, click this and see some information about our publication. Or if we click this badge, we can copy this badge, for example, in the markdown format and add this to the Readme file of the repository. Let's do that. So add the badge, commit the changes, and now we will see the DOI badge on the Readme file of this repository. The DOI badge is important because the DOI, which stands for Digital Object Identifier, gives us a unique identifier to our publication. We can also click this badge and we will now go to the Zenodo page of this publication where we will see some statistics about our publication. We can also edit the information about our publication. For example, if it's not a software but a publication or something else, we can choose these things here. Also, we can go down here to the export section where we'll have different citation styles that we can export the citation, for example, the BibTeX citation. We can also make the citation information available directly from a GitHub repository under the About section by including this citation.cff file to the repository. And we should use this CFF format for that. We can copy this CFF template, then head back to our repository and create a new file with the name citation.cff. Let's paste the information. Now let's modify this information with our own name and own information. Here we should use our own ORCID. I will copy it from my own ORCID profile. You should do the same. And then let's modify the title. And let's modify the version number. Let's copy the DOI of our own publication. We can do it easily from the generated BibTeX citation. We can do the same for the URL. Replace it here in the URL section. And then also let's replace the release date. Now we are ready to commit this file. And as we will see, the citation information has appeared here as this cite this repository button where it's available in these two formats. Thanks for watching this tutorial. I hope it was helpful, and I hope that together we can improve the state of research software engineering.